this problem, we have to find out the least values of x and y such that sine x minus y is half and cos x plus y is half. So sine x minus y equals to half from this equation we are getting. So the general solution will be, right, where n belongs to any integer. From the second equation we are getting, so x plus y, the general solution will be, is it clear? K belongs to any integer. From these two equations, if I add, we are going to get, okay, x will be least when the integer n equals to k is equals to 0. Therefore, we are getting 2x as, so we are having either pi by 2 or minus pi by 6. So from here we are getting x as either pi by 4 or minus pi by 12. But minus pi by 12 we have to reject, because we are here to find out the least positive values of x. Therefore x will be nothing but pi by 4, which is the least value of x, right? From the second equation we can write y as, so replace the value of x as pi by 4, which is the least value of x, and putting k equals to 0, we are getting the least value of y will be, so y will be either, that gives you, or y will be equals to, this we are not calculating because from here you are going to get the value which is negative, but here we are finding out the positive values of y, okay? Therefore, the least positive value of y will be pi by 12. And that of x will be pi by 4. Is it clear to all of you? Let us move for the next problem. Here we have to find out the general solution of x. So we have been given tan squared 2x plus cot squared 2x. For this part, we are using the formula a squared plus b squared we are getting. A plus b whole square minus 2ab. Tan 2x into cot 2x will give you 1. That is why I have written only minus 2. Now let us assume that tan 2x cot 2x is a. Therefore the equation becomes, is it okay? Now by factorizing we are going to get, so either a is 2 or a is minus 4, right? Now when a is 2, that is, so we are having, so from here we can write, but remember in this case your 2x is not equals to n pi, that implies x is not equals to n pi by 2, otherwise this part will become undefined. So we are getting, that implies tan 2x is 1. From here we can write 2x equals to, 1 can be written as tan pi by 4. Therefore 2x will be equals to, from here we can write x is nothing but n pi by 2 plus pi by 4, where n belongs to any integer. Is it clear? The other part is a equals to minus 4, that is, again the same way, in this case also your 2x cannot be a multiple of pi. So from here we are getting tan 2x as, which is equals to, so either the value of tan 2x is minus 2 plus root 3, or it will be minus 2 minus root 3. Is it clear? From the first one we are getting, if I take a minus common, it will be 2 minus root 3. Now can you tell me what will be the value of tan which will give you 2 minus root 3? It is 15 degree. This can be written as tan minus pi by 12. Is it okay? Therefore your 2x will be, where k belongs to any integer. So your x will be, is it okay? When k belongs to any integer. Now, the other value is, which can also be written as, which is same as, is it clear? 2 minus root 3 is basically the value of tan 15 degree. So 1 by tan 15 degree will give you cot 15 degree. So it is minus cot pi by 12. Is it clear? Now this can be written as, okay, so we are having what? Let me rub this portion. So we are having 2x equals to m pi plus 7 pi by 12, where m belongs to any integer. So from here we are getting x as m pi by 2 plus 7 pi by 24. Is it clear? Therefore, the general solution of x that we got are this one, and this one. Is it clear to all of you? Have you understood it clearly? Move for the next problem. Now, in this problem, we have been given that cot cube theta plus, let me take 2 common. So 3 cosec 2 theta can be written as 3 by sine 2 theta minus 4 by sine cube 2 theta, correct? Equals to 0. Now, little simplification will give you. Now here remember one thing, that sine 2 theta cannot be equals to 0 implies 2 theta cannot be equals to n pi implies theta cannot be equals to n pi by 2. Remember this one. I'm writing it here. Your theta is not equals to n pi by 2. Clear? So from here we are getting, again in this case also, your theta cannot be equals to n pi. Have you understood it? Why? Because if theta is n pi, then your sine cube theta will become 0 and the whole expression will become undefined. Therefore, your theta cannot take any value which is equals to n pi, where n is an integer. Now, let me take LCM. This implies, so either sine cube theta equals to 0 or this part equals to 0. But sine cube theta cannot be equals to 0, as you have already said that theta is not equals to n pi. So the second part is equals to 0. I'm sorry, here it will be 8. Thus, 8 cos to the power 6 theta plus 6 sine squared 2 theta minus 8 equals to 0. This is the only possibility that it can be equals to 0, because the first part cannot be equals to 0. So from here we are getting, is it clear? Sine square theta, I'm replacing it with 1 minus cos square theta. So we are having basically, so we are having, it can also be written as, so we are having cos square theta minus 1 whole cube equals to 0 implies cos square theta equals to 1, which is equals to cos 0. So that implies your theta will be equals to n pi. Is it clear? But you have already said that the given equation will be defined when theta is not equals to n pi. And in this solution, we are getting theta equals to n pi. Therefore,
From this equation, you are not going to get any real values of theta. Hence, no solution is the answer. Have you understood it? Absolutely. Okay. Now, this part is very, very important. Maximum students forget to do this step. And if they miss this step, observe it carefully. The students will give the answer as n pi, which will be absolutely wrong. Is it clear? So be careful while doing the sum. Let us move for the next problem. Now in this problem, before starting the sum, we know that sine 3x is 3 sine x minus 4 sine cube x. So from here we are getting that sine cube x is it clear? Therefore, the given equation, the left hand side of the given equation will transform into is it clear to all of you? Now, we are applying sin c plus sin d formula for these two expressions. So we are getting sin 3x minus 2 pi. So if I take a minus common, so it will be minus sin 2 pi minus 3x. Now again, sin 2 pi minus 3x will give you minus sin 3x. So this thing will transform into plus sine 3x. Is it clear to all of you? Sine 2 pi plus theta will give you sine 3x again, which is equals to 0. Now, cos 2 pi by 3 is nothing but minus half. So this thing will become so the first expression, this expression will become 0. Implies sin 3x is 0 implies 3x equals to n pi, where n belongs to any integer. X is nothing but n pi by 3. Is it clear? So this is the general solution for this equation. Is it clear to all of you? Move for the next problem. Here we have been given that theta is lying between 0 and 2 pi, and the given equation is, now in this case also, your sine theta cannot be equals to 0 implies theta cannot be equals to n pi. Is it clear? Now in the given range 0 to 2 pi, so in this problem, your theta cannot be equals to pi. So if I take 1 minus 2 sine theta common, we are left with, is it okay? So either cot theta is minus 1 or sine theta is half. Now cot theta is minus 1. Within the range 0 to 2 pi, we are going to get the values of theta as 3 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4. Is it okay? Sin theta equals to half. Within the range 0 to 2 pi, we are going to get the values of theta are pi by 6 and 5 pi by 6. Therefore, the required values of theta are pi by 6, 5 pi by 6, 3 pi by 4, and 7 pi by 4. Is it clear? Actually, the question they have given is find the general solution. Since the range is given to us, so it should not be general solution. It should be what are the values of theta lying between 0 and 2 pi such that this equation will satisfy. In that case, your theta will take the values pi by 6, 5 pi by 6, 3 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4. Is it clear to all of you? Okay.